Everything I do in these videos is purely for experimenting with documentary-style content and should not be repeated at home. I see an awful picture. Lifeless ants strewn everywhere. Take a look, right here. Upon closer examination, it was clear that dead ants were in abundance. It was a tough situation to grasp. Initially, I couldn't fathom the cause or the sequence of events. My initial thought was that perhaps some ants couldn't find their way out and perished due to hunger or thirst. But then, it all made sense. Hey everyone, Timon speaking. As you might recall from our previous video, I introduced a mini maze, attaching it to my Formicarium with a glass tube, setting the stage for our ant adventure. We wanted to observe how the ants would navigate this maze and whether they could uncover the hidden seeds. You can catch the previous video. The results were completely unexpected. But the surprises didn't stop there. Today, I approached the labyrinth only to be greeted by a disheartening sight. Deceased ants scattered everywhere. Just take a look over here. Upon closer examination, it was clear that dead ants were in abundance. It was a tough situation to grasp. Initially, I couldn't fathom the cause or the sequence of events. My initial thought was that perhaps some ants couldn't find their way out and perished due to hunger or thirst. But then, it all made sense. Looking at this pile of garbage, in my previous video, I mentioned that the ants seemed to deposit a significant amount of sand into the labyrinth, which left me perplexed. But now I realized that the labyrinth was accumulating trash, including seed husks and, of course, dead ants. In essence, these ants were found close to the exit. They may have not died here. They could have left at any time. Plus, they had access to water and food. These are the fallen ants, transported here by their fellow ants from various colonies. The reason they scattered them throughout the maze remains a mystery. Now, let's shift our focus to the Formicarium itself. It's impeccably clean. Just look at the sand. There's not a speck of trash. My hypothesis stands confirmed. The ants have taken it upon themselves to clean their habitat, relegating waste to the labyrinth. Hence, the presence of dead ants here is primarily due to natural causes, old age, if you will. These ants had been lying around at different times, and for some reason, the other ants decided to create a burial ground within this labyrinth. It carries an air of mystery, doesn't it? Though quite compact. Oh, and take a peek at the seeds. It seems they haven't been sourced from this labyrinth at all. They've been neatly arranged here, compactly stored. It's a bit puzzling. Maybe they have enough seeds here, or this is their designated storage spot. It's a fact, even if it's a bit disconcerting. These seeds have been left undisturbed despite the ants' bustling activities. They've extensively explored the labyrinth, becoming well acquainted with the ins and outs. By the way, you might notice a fly's wing. A flashback to our earlier video where the ants were in hot pursuit of a fly. This particular wing narrates the tale. Now, many of you have been curious about my Xiaomi aquarium's progress. Let's take a look. I've placed it in what I like to call my relaxation corner, where I brainstorm video scripts. Above me, the gold and silver buttons glisten, and there's the aquarium. As you can see, the top plant is no longer standing as it failed to take root. It's a bit of a design mystery as it couldn't thrive underwater. It might require a different type of plant. Additionally, keen observers will note the absence of algae on the second plant. For some reason, it didn't establish itself and had to be removed, which had a significant impact on the water quality. In my opinion, it's now in better shape, providing ample space for the fish. The plant you see is Vesicularia dubiana, the haven for my shrimp. Speaking of which, you might spot a dark shrimp hiding here, and lo and behold, there's another one over there. They tend to keep to themselves, occasionally paddling about. By the way, this moss is very interesting. It grows by itself without further pretensions. The fish, as you can see, are quite active, constantly on the lookout for their daily feed. I provide them with food once a day to prevent overfeeding. Now, observe the shrimp, especially the daring red one. One of them is bolder than the rest. It's the first to grab a bite once the food is served. You'll notice their coordinated dance to collect any stray morsels, keeping the tank water clean. In conclusion, the aquarium is in excellent condition, boasting pristine water and contented fish. I couldn't be more satisfied with its compact and cozy setup. That's all for today. I wish you a splendid evening, and above all, stay healthy.